Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Create and Process. In today's video, we'll look at how you can create off these amazing text effects in Photoshop. We'll be using blur option to create out this design. In the previous video, we have seen how I can use radial blur option to create out some amazing text effect. We have used radial spin blur to create this cone, then we have applied it to a text and this using the spin blur option. In this tutorial, we're going to create out these three designs. So for the first design, we have used Gaussian blur. Then I have applied a filter gallery, distort gloss to create this gloss effect. And then for the second design, we have used box blur, tilt shift blur, and added a nice shadow to it. And for the third design, we have used zoom blur option, and we have used a color overlay using the layer style panel. So let's begin with the designing process. So here's our first design. Let's create this. So to create this design, I'm going to open a new Photoshop document and set the dimension to 500 by 500. Okay, 72 resolution and create. So here we go. Now I'll fill this up with black color. So Alt Backspace, and now let's type our text. So just click and press O. And here we go. This is the text. So I'm gonna scale this up, Command Control T. And with the Alt press, just scale it up from center and place it somewhere around here. And enter. So here we go, we have created a text. Now let's apply the effects. So to create this effect, what we're gonna do is we're gonna convert this into a smart object first, and now let's apply tilt shift blur. So go to filter, blur gallery, and tilt shift. We got lots of other blur options here, but for this tutorial, for this design, I'm going to use this tilt shift, and let's look at it. So here it is. So by default, it will be like this. You can move around anywhere on the design. So just place it in the center, and we're going to give this from here. So I'm going to just bring this closer to the center, and this edge, I'll just make it along the border of the text, so like this. Now we're gonna adjust the blur value. So here you can adjust the blur value. So how much blur you want to give. So let's increase the blur value around, let's say 25, and distortion will increase it to full. So as you can see, distortion is there, and just check the symmetric distortion. So it will apply on both top and bottom. So as you can see, I can reduce it, I can increase it. So keep it 100% and just adjust this value. So make it softer, something like this, and click OK. And the effect is applied to our text. Now the next thing we're gonna do is to apply noise to it. So to apply a noise, I'll go to filter, noise, add noise, and here let's keep it uniform and also make sure that's monochromatic so that we get a black and white color, something like this, right? And you can adjust the amount here. So you want something detailed textures here, adding noise. So let's keep it a little darker. And let's see, let's say I think this is fine. I'll keep it 110 and click OK. So we have added noise. Now the next thing I'm gonna apply is box blur, because as you can see, the edge here is a little sharper. So what I need is I need one more blur option. So I'll go to filter, blur, and box blur. So let's check it out what happens if you apply a box blur. Just click on it and you can just blur out everything. So what I needed for this design is adding simple slight blur. So I'll keep it around 2%. Like 2 pixels, and click OK, and make sure your box blur is on the bottom, so that way it will be applied only to the background white surface, just this, and texture will be visible very clearly. And now next thing I'm gonna do is to apply gradient map. So double click on here and apply gradient overlay, right? And this will give you that depth of field using the shade. So over here, go into our gradient overlay now and just go to gradient, and here you can choose the gradient color. So you can give any color code, but for this design we need very simple gray stone. So let's select this gradient color, black and white, and let's set a light grayish color over here, and we'll place it somewhere around here just to get this effect, and click OK. And you can just adjust the scale slider just to give how much shade you want to give to your design, and once you're happy, just click OK, and here we go. And lastly, to enhance the colors, just apply brightness and contrast over here, increase the contrast and reduce the brightness just to make it sharper, something like that. And we'll add a curve just to make it a little more brighter. So increase the brightness, and here you can just make it a little bit contrasty, and just adjust the sliders just to get how much details you want to show. And here we go. If you zoom it out, you can see that nice effect is applied. So that's how we have applied some tilt shift blur, box blur, and added noise to your text effect. Now the next thing we're going to design is this. So we're going to create this design, and it's very simple. We're going to type our text, give some color code, and then we'll apply Gaussian blur and the filter gallery, that's glass effect. So let's create this. So open a new Photoshop document. So open a new Photoshop document with a dimension 1500 by 1500 resolution 72 and create. And here we go. We got a new document here. First of all, let's type our text. So let's type any text, something like V and Command Control T, and let's scale this up with the Alt pressed. And here we go. The text is here. Now, after you have got your text, the first thing we're gonna do is to apply these colors. If I hide this effect, you can see it's a color. So we'll apply this color by dividing into various shapes. So let's create this. So I'm gonna use this append tool to create the shapes. So we'll divide it into total 5 divisions are there, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So let's create that. Click, let's zoom it in and click. We'll give one click over here and just finish this. And let's apply some color. So we're gonna fill it up with plain color and let's apply some dark color, something like this. Okay, and after that, we'll create a few more shapes using the pen tool. So just click there, click at this point, and one over here, and just over there. Now I'll just apply some little lighter tone over there. In the same way, we'll create other piece over here. Let's fill this up with some different color, something blue, and now we'll do the same for the other, and we'll fill this up with different color. So let's pick some bluish tint, something like that, and let's give a different shape with this triangular, and let's apply some color, something like that. Now once you have created these shapes, you can edit it using the die selection tool. So click there, zoom it in, and just make sure you have placed the points correctly over there. You can do it with each of the individual shapes if you feel like you need the adjustments. So I feel like it's good for me. Now let's do the color adjustment. So let's see this, and I'll just drag and drop it there just to pick the color so you'll be able to see it. Control D, okay, and just scale it down and place it somewhere around here. Now let's pick the color. So what I need is, I need this purple color, magenta. So let's select this text, text tool, and let's pick a color. So the color we're gonna use is this one. So here's the color around here, and the color code is CF3086. Next color we're gonna use is this one. So I'll just select the shape. As you can see, this is the shape, and using the shape tool, go over here and pick a color from here, dark red, something like that, and click OK. We'll do the same for the others, selecting this, go over there, and we'll pick something like this, and okay, something like that, and we'll pick this blue color, and let's pick some light blue color from here. So this is the color, and color code is 00D8FF, so apply the color code and you'll get the exact color. We'll do the same for this one. We'll select that and just pick a color from here. So it's dark purple, so somewhere on here and there, and you can copy this color code to get similar color. And lastly, this piece, triangular piece, so selecting that. Okay, let's see which is this. So this is the shape. Now we'll pick the color from here, and we're gonna give some dark blue color somewhere around here, deep blue, and around here, dark blue. Okay, and once you have applied the colors, and you can just select everything. I'll just delete this now, and now we'll select all these layer including the background, right, and convert them into smart object, and that way we got a single text of color. And what I'll do is I'll add one more layer for the background and fill this up with white color. So once you've applied white color in the background, and here's our smart object. Now next thing we're gonna do is to apply Gaussian blur, something like this. So let's apply Gaussian blur. So selecting that, go to filter, blur, and Gaussian blur, and here we go. And to this we're gonna give around, as you can see, we have to see some details over here. You can increase it, but it will blur out too much. You're not able to see the details. What we need is, we need to blur in such a way we can see the text as well, similar to around 43, something like that. So make sure it's visible in this same manner and click OK. Now we'll apply filter gallery. So we'll go to filter, filter gallery, and here you find some options over here. So under distort you see glass, and here it is. So we're going to create this. So we'll do some adjustments with this. This is the glass, so you can increase the smoothness around here. So I have given very low smoothness just to see that, get that crispy glass effect. And this is a distortion, so you can increase the distortion amount how much. So I have given a very high amount just to see this crystal clear details. And scaling, you can scale the size of this detail, so you can just make it bigger or very tiny. So I'll keep it in between, and here it is, and click OK, and you got a nice glass effect there. Now in the next step, what I've done is I have after applying the Gaussian blur, we have masked out the region where you don't want to show the effect. So let's do it. So selecting this, select the brush tool B and just paint it over it. So you can see the foreground color is black. So just paint over the region where you don't want to show this effect. So just go here and just paint it over here, and do the same for the other side as well until here, and just paint it over there. Remove everything, something like this. Very simple, very easy. Do the same for the bottom as well. Just go there and we'll blend it with the ending. So just make sure it should blend with the flow of the text. So I'm just deleting out all the extra. And once you got that effect, nice effect there, you're able to see the same style there, and here it is. And you can anytime go into filter gallery. We'll reduce the smoothness just to see these details on top. So we'll keep it around 2, and scaling you can adjust it and click OK. So that's how you can see such details in your design, and you can apply this to any text, any shape you like. And you can go to curve and just make sure you're giving some brightness just to add that nice glow effect to your text effect. And that's how you create the second design using the Gaussian blur option. Now the third design we're going to create out this is this text, and it's very simple. We have used zoom blur option. In the previous video we have used radial option where you have used spin blur. And this time we're going to use radial zoom blur option. So to create this, let's open a new Photoshop document, and we'll set it around 500 by 400. Okay. And create. And let's see what we're going to do over here. So I'll just place it beside our design just to work on it very easily. And here, if you check out our text effect, you see there are lots of layers of text. So we have given a grading color to the text border, and we have applied some radial blur. So zoom, radial zoom blur. If I double click on here, you can see this is the spin and this is zoom. This one we have learned it in a previous tutorial. And now we're going to look at how we can use zoom to this text. So let's create it from this basic. So I'm going to apply black color to this first. Okay. Now I'm going to type our text, N-E-O-N, neon. Come on, control T. And place it around here. So here we go, and let's scale this down a little bit and enter. So here's our text. Now next thing we're gonna do is to remove the fill color. So I'll just remove the fill color and double click, and I'll apply a stroke, and under stroke we're gonna give some thickness. So let's give some thickness around, make sure it's inside center. So make sure it's center and just give some thickness. So I think 4 is fine, and we're gonna give some color to this. So here under color, choose gradient, and under gradient you'll see lots of gradient option. You can choose anything from here, but what we're gonna do is we're gonna use this color. This is the gradient I have prepared earlier. So I'm gonna show you the color code just to get it. So there are 4 sliders. The first one is green, so use this light green color using the color code 09F1B8. The second color code is blue, so this is the color code 0082FF. Third is magenta with this color code FF00D2, and the last is yellow. So using these 4 color codes, I have created this gradient color, and click OK. And after that, adjust the angle something like this. I have given 0 degree just to make sure it's going from left to right in the gradient order, and click OK. Now after this, we're gonna create a duplicate of this just for backup. Okay, and I'll hide this original layer. Now this one we're going to convert this into smart object, and let's start applying the zoom blur option. So selecting this layer, go to filter, blur, radial blur. Under radial blur you get zoom, so select zoom, and let's give first zoom amount, so we're going to increase it to around 18. So first make sure it's 18, and make sure dimension is 500 by 400 pixel with 70 resolution, so that you can use the same value I'm going to use. So for the first option, for the first layer, I'm going to use 80 amount with a zoom, and make sure it's in center and click OK. So you got a nice blur there. We're going to create on the duplicate of this, so just click and drag it down and create a duplicate, and again double click on the radial blur, and this time increase it to 45, and you get under layer of blur, zoom blur, something like this. We'll create a duplicate of this, and this time we'll increase it to 65. So I'm just increasing the values just to make it, as you can see there are layers forming, so we're going to create some layers. Click OK, and here we go, 1, 2, 3 layers out there, and this is the three layers we're going to use. And after this, once you have created these three layers, and select all the three layers and create under duplicate of them, and change the blend mode to linear.add, and this will give you that nice glow text effect there. Very interesting. If you check out the original design, it's the same color effect, and here we go. You got a nice design, very simple, very easy, and with it, very simple steps, just applying the zoom blur and just changing the blend mode to linear dodge. And if you want to reduce the intensity, you can just go in there and reduce the opacity as per unit, but I think 100% is fine. Now there is one more thing, we need to add these glow, stroke glow effects. Here you can see there are strokes, so let's add that. So for that we're going to use the original one, so just open this and just bring it on the top of the layers. So select them and bring it on top somewhere on there, and I'll just go in there, okay, and open the stroke, and under stroke change this gradient to color and keep it white, and I'll reduce the stroke to around 4 is fine, I think, for keep it 4, and change the blend mode to overlay. So change the blend mode to overlay, and this will add those strokes to the highlighted region, and where there's no highlight you're not able to see that, and we'll keep it that way. Now create another duplicate of this, and this time we're going to use it to give a thin stroke thickness. So again, go inside stroke and reduce the stroke thickness to around 2, and to see the effects on our design we'll change the blend mode to screen, and you get to see this nice thin glow effect there, and I think this looks fine. Click OK, and here we go, and you can reduce the opacity a little bit just to give some nice cool effect there. Do the same for the other as well, and here we go, we have created the third design as well. Let's change the background color now. So double click on the layer, okay, and open layer style panel, choose gradient overlay or color overlay as per your requirement, and let's make it dark blue, similar to this, and click OK. And that's how we have created this nice text effect using zoom blur option. So overall, in this tutorial we have seen how you can create some amazing text effect using blur option. So there are lots of other blur options which we can cover in the next coming up tutorials. So here we go, we have created all these three designs. We have used Gaussian blur and added a nice gloss effect using filter gallery option. For the second design we have used box blur, tilt shift blur, and added a nice texture using noise option. And lastly, for this third design we have used zoom blur option, created out this amazing text effect. In the next episode we're gonna cover some more amazing text effects using Illustrator and Photoshop. I hope you enjoy this tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up, and if you want more updates on designing, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to the channel. Thank you.